In this power electronics session, we are going to see about the load commutator chopper. In the previous videos, we have seen about the voltage commutator chopper and current commutator chopper. So in this video session, we can see about this load commutator chopper. In this method, the conducting SCR is turned off when the load current flowing through the SCR either becomes zero due to the nature of the load circuit parameters, or the load current is transferred to another device from conducting SCR. Okay, by these methods we can turn off the SCR. We can see how we are going to turn off the SCR by using this method. Okay, so before seeing the operation, we can see what are the components we are using in this chopper. There are four thyristors or SCRs, T1, T2, T3, T4. Four thyristors are used here, where T1, T2 act as a pair and T3, T4 act as a pair. Okay, this is the capacitor. Okay, capacitor is connected, and the freewheeling diode which is connected across this load. So when the thyristors T1, T2, okay, when this pair is conducting, this T3, T4 pair and capacitor acts as a commutating components. Okay, when the thyristors T3, T4 are conducting, the thyristor T1 and T2 and the capacitor, okay, these will be acting as a commutating components. So in this load commutator chopper, we are going to assume that the load current is constant. Okay, that is, the output current is constant, and also the capacitor is initially charged with the voltage with negative polarity in the upper plate and positive polarity in the lower plate. Okay, with this assumption, we can see the operation. There are three modes of operation. Okay, we can see one by one. In the first mode, the thyristors T1 and T2 will be triggered. Okay, so when these two thyristors are triggered, the current flow will be like this through this path. Okay, the current flows through this thyristor 1, capacitor, thyristor 2, and through this load. Okay, so it will be the path of the load current. Then what about this output voltage? Since the capacitor is initially charged with the voltage Vs, okay, the output voltage V0 is equal to this supply voltage plus capacitor voltage. That is, V0 is equal to Vs plus Vs. That is, the output voltage is V0 is equal to Vs plus Vs, which is equal to 2 Vs. So the output voltage will be 2 Vs. Okay, since the capacitor is charged with the voltage Vs. So we can see here in the waveform. So this is that mode 1. At time 0, we are triggering the thyristors T1 and T2. Okay, these are the pulses, that is, gate pulses which are given to this thyristors T1 and T2. Okay, since we are giving this gate pulse, the thyristor T1 and T2, okay, it starts its conduction. This is the current IT1, IT2 flowing through the thyristors T1 and T2. Okay, so what is the capacitor voltage? So initially it is charged with the voltage Vs. Okay, then again it is discharged. So the output voltage is V0 is equal to Vs plus Vs, that is 2 Vs. At the end of this mode, this capacitor voltage becomes minus Vs. Okay, so at the end of this mode 1, the output voltage also becomes 0, because since the capacitor voltage becomes minus Vs, the output voltage V0 is equal to Vs plus Vc, that is capacitor voltage plus supply voltage. Okay, here the capacitor voltage becomes minus Vs, so Vs minus Vs, which is equal to 0. So the output voltage becomes 0. At the end of this mode 1, the output voltage is 0. So this is the charging current. Okay, this is the freewheeling diode current. So it is 0 because it is not in conduction mode in this mode 1. This is the current flow through the thyristors T1 and T2. Since the thyristors T3, T4 are off now, there is no current flow. And since the thyristors T1 and T2 are conducting, there is no voltage across it. And the reverse voltage is applied across this thyristors T3 and T4 by the capacitor. Okay, so this is the mode 1 operation. As we assume to see here, this is the output current which is constant. Okay, since we are using the freewheeling diode, the output current is constant. then we can see the mode 2. In mode 2, the capacitor is slightly overcharged. Okay, since it is overcharged, this freewheeling diode comes to the conduction state. So the current, output current, freewheels through this path. Okay, here in this mode, four thyristors are in the off state. Okay, so we can see the waveform. So in this second mode, the capacitor voltage is minus Vs and the output voltage is zero. Okay, but the output current is maintained. Okay, output current is I naught. Since the freewheeling diode comes to the conduction state, the current flows, that is I naught current flows through this freewheeling diode. So this is the I naught current which flows through this freewheeling diode. Okay, this is the I naught current which flows through this freewheeling diode. Then the T1, T2 are turned off. Okay, by the reverse voltage of this capacitor. Okay, since the reverse voltage of this capacitor is applied across the thyristors T1 and T2, these are turned off now in this mode. And what about the current through this thyristor T3 and T4? Okay, so these thyristors are also not conducting, so there is no current flow through the thyristors T3 and T4. And voltage, okay, T3, T4 are off, so reverse voltage is going to be applied across it. Since the now in at the end of this mode 1 itself, this thyristors T3 and T4 will be the forward biased and the voltage will be Vs. Okay, so this is the mode 2. In mode 3, already this thyristors T1, T2 are turned off by the reverse voltage of this capacitor. Okay, now the thyristors T3, T4 are already in forward biased condition. Now we are going to trigger these thyristors. So if we trigger, the output current will flow through this thyristor T4, capacitor T3 and through this load. Okay, it will take this path. So now the output voltage will be again 2 Vs. See here, the output voltage is 2 Vs in this mode again, and the capacitor voltage is going to reduce from minus Vs. Okay, so it is moving towards, it is going to charge towards the Vs. So at the end of this mode 3, the voltage becomes plus Vs, and the end of this mode 3, the output voltage becomes 0. What about the charging current? That is minus I naught. Then the freewheeling diode, it is not in the conduction state now, so there is no current flow through the freewheeling diode. Then the thyristors T1, T2 are turned off. T3, T4 are conducting now, so the current I naught is flowing through the thyristors T3 and T4. Across T2, T1, the reverse voltage is applied by the capacitor. In this mode, since T3, T4 are conducting, there is no voltage across it. Okay, so this is the mode 3. Again, at the end of this mode 3, the capacitor will be overcharged and the freewheeling diode comes to the conduction state and the output current freewheels through the freewheeling diode and load. Okay, so the output current will be constant. So this these modes will be repeating again and again. Okay, so the modes of operation of the load commutator chopper. Now we can see the merits of this load commutator chopper. So it is capable of commutating any high amount of load current. Okay, so with this method we can commutate any amount of load current. Then in voltage commutator chopper and current commutator chopper, we used inductor and capacitor as commutating components. But here we are not using the inductor, only capacitor we are using. So since we are not using the commutating inductor, okay, the circuit becomes less noisy and less bulky. If the inductor is used, then the circuit becomes bulky and noisy, and also it becomes very costly. Okay, since the inductor is not used here, we have the merits of reducing the cost and the bulkiness and then noise. Okay, so this is the second merit. Then third one, chopper can work at high frequencies in the order of kilohertz. Okay, so this since it is working in high frequencies or sufficient. These are the demerits. So the peak voltage is equal to the twice the value of supply voltage. That is V naught is equal to 2 Vs we had. Okay. However, this peak voltage can be reduced by the filtering. Then for high power applications, the efficiency become low because this chopper is used in high frequency operation. Okay. So it can be used for high frequency operation. Since it is operating in high frequencies, the switching losses become more. Since the losses are more, the efficiency will be low. Okay. Then the freewheeling diode is also subjected to the twice of the supply voltage. This is also another demerit. The commutating capacitor. Okay. It also has to carry the full load current at a frequency of off the chopping frequency. Then the last demerit is when one pair of thyristors are turned on, another pair, okay, other pair is commutated. That is, at the time when two thyristors are turned on, two thyristors are acting as a commutating components. So this can be done by sensing the capacitor current, which is alternating. Okay, so these are the demerits of the load commutated chopper. In this video session, we have seen the modes of operation, merits and demerits of the load commutator chopper. Thank you.